I'm Dr. Philip Yu. I'm the founder of the 21st Century Regenerative Medicine Institute here in Orange County, California. Actually, you can see Disneyland. See those hotels? Those are Disneyland hotels, Anaheim Convention Center. We call this our Disneyland Experience Clinic, okay? Happiest place in the world. We have all this technology. It's like going on a different ride. Kind of like this is Star Wars land. That's where you're at. But this is Star Wars or Star Trek medicine. So earlier we filmed Michael's laser-guided stem cell therapy for his plantar fasciitis. And since he's a director, he has to stand all the time. It's not like in Hollywood where they show you the director's chair. He's actually working on his feet. We want to make sure he can continue that. And then his knees started to wear out from a ski accident. So we want to repair the cartilage damage here and do a preventative one for his right knee so the knees grow evenly so you don't create a short leg. We're going to do this under knee decompression. So what this device does, it's going to open up the lateral knee joint because he has what's called genu valgus, which is a knock knee like that. So this is going to open up the lateral knee to create space where the needle's going to go in like butter and the cells will just go in there, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and mark the points we're going to graft the cells. This is an infrared laser thermometer. And we're going to mark the areas of greatest inflammation in the lateral knee joint. So you see there's more inflammation inferior, so I'm going to mark that. There's not a lot of space in there, that's why we do the traction here. Is that pull not too bad?
It's not too bad.
Okay. Okay, what I'm going to do is I want to create more space. I might put that up a few more pounds. When they repaired this, they didn't put any hardware in there, right?
Yeah, there's two screws.
Okay, but it's down here, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. Michelle, we're gonna stay superficial. You don't have to, don't feel like the needle has to go too deep on this point.
Right.
Not a lot of space in there.
Yeah.
So we're gonna put some here, as much as you can fill it out. The rest we'll put superiorly. Okay, my favorite point, which is away from the supra.
Do you want to gather yourself together?
Yeah.
Or do you want to stay asleep?
You could give her 10 more minutes on that.
Okay, I'll give you 10 more. Oh, she's all nice and warm.
Yeah, that's right here. Yeah, this is going to put the majority of the cells here.
There we go. It's not too warm, is it?
No.
Okay.
Let me mark out that knee right there. I just did a do-si-do right there. Again, we want to put it in the area of greatest inflammation. Is it tender here at all?
A little bit.
Long arms.
More tender here?
Yeah.
More tender here, right?
Long arms.
Like I know those points. So we're going to put it superiorly, which is, I like this point because it's away from the supra. Patellar fat pad so you can get in the joint better. Okay, all right, we have our points. So we'll start out with the left knee, which is the worst one. All right. So we have 5 cc's of allograft. We mix it with bicarbonate to make an alkaline environment to help the cells grow. We'll put 3 here, 1 here, 3, 4, and 1 here, okay? So we'll put the majority here. I'll start with that. Let's try to get 3 in there. All right, we're gonna use cryo spray to numb the area. So you will not notice the needle as much. That's a good angle right there. Turn that on for 30 minutes, please. Is that about the deepest you can get it?
I can go deeper.
Okay, yeah, let's get it as deep as we can. Get it in that joint capsule. So the knee is a capsule with fluid in it. As long as you get the needle inside the capsule in the lateral knee, it'll go into the lateral joint space. So.
It's getting full.
Okay. How many cc's did we get in?
I haven't counted. I need to turn the catheter over.
If you got a blockage, use the fanning method. Just pull it out and get a different angle.
I'm getting a little more at this angle.
Okay, good.
Are you okay there?
You got a bandy ready?
Good.
It's fine. It's okay.
Okay, Mike?
Yep.
Yeah. Tell me when you feel pressure, if at all.
I'm good.
Okay. That's a good point, huh?
Yeah, I fanned it, I moved it a little bit, and I gave me a little more space. A lot more space. Okay. So we're at... still have three left.
So okay, let's put in one more. Yeah. So we're putting most of the cells in the lateral left knee. That was the most damage caused from the ski accident. Went over a mogul and just went down like that, which tore the lateral meniscus. And now, you know, with the bone-on-bone arthritis, we want to graft the cells into the lateral knee, because that's where the genuvalgus is causing the bone-on-bone osteoarthritis. Look at that. Bloodless, mosquito-less. Maybe a fully mosquito bite, be honest. Maybe two mosquitoes?
Maybe one and a half.
Okay, one and a half mosquitoes, not bad, all right?
Right.
And now we'll get the inferior lateral knee. And this is closer to where the damage was. This one's gonna be really superficial, just so you know. Another 10 minutes for Carla on that? Yeah. Probably enjoys that. Okay. You're gonna go like right perpendicular. There's a bone spur, so right where my nail mark is basically. I'll mark it with the scanner. So you're gonna go in at this angle right there. Perfect.
We'll do about one.
Yeah, as much as you get in, up to one.
Oh yeah, the traction really.
Yeah, that helps. Yeah, see the decompression. That's the key to open up that joint.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it goes in like butter, literally. The band-aid ready. Yeah. Oh, that was so smooth. Okay. Go ahead and dab that.
All right. Perfect.
Oh, you got.
Yes, ma'am.
And then we're gonna get a light stem panel to further activate those cells. You want to put that over her knee. See?
There we go.
And after we do this knee, we'll do the myofascial release tool procedure to activate those cells. Yep, just like the other one, you can go right perpendicular right in there.
I'm just ready for this. I cleaned it.
Clean, okay. Mm-hmm. I'll go spray for you. It's my favorite part.
The cryo spray?
Yeah.
Little pinch.
It's kind of cool how fast it takes effect. Yeah. From an analgesic effect.
Yeah. I don't like lidocaine because some people are allergic to it. And we try to stay drug-free.
Right.
And who knows if the lidocaine is affecting those cells.
Right.
Killing them or whatever, so.
Could have negative interactions.
Exactly.
With the stem cells.
Uh-huh. And we're just grafting this knee. It is starting to get valgus or knock knee, so it's more of a prevention, so you don't put as much fluid in there. Okay. And so, yeah, again, she was like 3 out of 4, no blood really. And what we're going to do is support that paracrine signaling, which is causing acute local inflammation, kind of like a prolotherapy injection, if you will. So again, I'm going to irritate the lateral knee joint to spread those cells in the target tissue.
Down. Okay, looking good too.
This thing might be better mic so you can get.
Yep.
Coming trying on. To push the band-aid away from it so I could kind of get in there. I don't want the band-aid to fall off. Feel those adhesions, the sandpaper.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the tools also help break down adhesions and scar tissue, which is dysfunctional tissue, and then even these like calcific spurs.
Right.
And it'll kind of make a clean scaffolding for the cells to create healthy connective tissue, cartilage.
Mm-hmm.
Again, we gave you two types of umbilical cord Wharton's jelly. One is derived from the membrane. It has like hyaluronic acid, all the growth factors to rebuild the connective tissue in the knee,
right.
Cartilage. And the other one has the mesenchymal stem cells from the umbilical cord blood. And those stem cells act like foramen to tell your body cells how to repair.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you're getting both, so you have a full array of the growth factors. So we leave nothing to chance, in other words.
No cell unturned,
yeah, exactly. So just the combination of both tissues, it just gives great clinical results.
Mm-hmm.
Out of all the knee procedures, we have yet to see a bona fide failed case, which means everyone's gotten at least 30 to 95% relief of their pain, better function. You saw the Helen's video,
mm-hmm.
You know, the 80-year-old who could squat down on her knees without pain after a month. I mean, that's incredible. And a lot of people are kind of scheduled for a knee replacement, and to get results like this is, you know, really remarkable. Yeah, right there.
Yep.
So after we irritate the tissue again, we're going to support that with the light stem panel that can get those cells to grow. And basically, we will do this for this side. Looks like his plantar fasciitis. We'll just give him a little more stimulation with the light stem. Do you feel a nice heat down there?
Yeah,
yeah.
That's good.
Uh-huh.
Very good.
So what we'll do a 1 month follow-up, Michael. You're gonna come in and I'm gonna rescan your feet and knees,
mm-hmm.
See if the inflammation is reduced by then, and you know, kind of give you more permission to do more aggressive activities.
Right.
It's a good chance to let your body heal.
Mm-hmm.
So you wanna kind of be lazy about not feel like you have to do any strenuous exercise other than your normal walking.
Right.
Give the chance for the tissues to regenerate with the cells.
Okay.
So take it easy a month before we do the reevaluation, and you're going to eat an alkaline diet. We have suggestions, drink alkaline water.
Mm-hmm.
The cells grow better in an alkaline state. Ask any farmer, fruits and vegetables.
Right.
You know, they're more viable, they grow bigger with an alkaline state. In fact, cancer cannot live when your body's in an alkaline state. So
But most of the water and food we drink is acidic. You know, and that's what damages the cells. So yeah, We added a little what's called bicarbonate in the allograft fluids, and that'll make an alkaline environment to help the cells to grow. So we're kind of biohacking your body to repair itself with all this technology. And
right.
Yeah.
Good, right?
Yeah.
Anything that makes you not have to hurt and makes
you
feel better.
So it's kind of like you think of it, we're kind of doing surgery on the outside where we're not going inside and cutting and shaving and shaping. I'm kind of breaking it down with these myofascial release stainless steel tools on the outside, right? And then repairing it with the cells and, you know, regenerating it with the cells and the laser lights and everything. So
right. That's great.
And then you're going to wear those unloader wedges, the gray ones, which will help unload the pressure off the lateral part of your knees,
right.
Which will create a gap for the cells to regenerate. There's something called Wolf's Law, where if you load a joint, it's going to go bone on bone. But guess what? If you unload it, it has the ability to heal. And that's what we're doing with the unloader wedges and the regenerative medicine with the cells, supporting that with all these energy technologies to stimulate the cells to grow. Okay, so that's why we do it. We're going to do a 1 month follow-up again. The home light unit you're going to use, put on your lateral knees half hour a day on the bottom of your foot, and we'll just follow up from there.
Very good.
Thank you for watching. That's how we